Good morning students, welcome to your computer class. In the previous class we are discussing the topics in the introduction of email, and the topics were receiving an email message, sending an email message, then common email terms, writing style, smileys, abbreviation, stouting, and as well as features of email program. These all things we are discussing, and the left part are bounced message, signature, attachment, creating an email account in Gmail, how will you create an account in Gmail, then sending and receiving email in Gmail, and email etiquettes. Okay, and then there is an exercise session. Okay, so today let's see the little revision of the previous topics, and then we will go through the new topics. So without wasting time, coming to the textbook, as you have seen, the features of email program, once again I am telling you, new. Clicking this button allows you to write a new email message to someone. Reply. This button will allow you to send a reply to someone who has sent you an email. Means the person who is sending you a mail, if you want to reply or answer to that person, then you will click on reply. Reply to all. That means sometimes you are receiving an email which you are not the only recipient. Means that email has been sent to other people also. So pressing this button allows you to reply to all the email addresses from that email. Whatever the email addresses are with that email, your answer will reach to all the addresses. Then forward. This button will help you to forward a message that you have received to someone else. Okay, means you have received this message from someone else, then if you want to forward that message to some other person, use forward. Send and receive. Pressing this button will serve two functions. The first, it will query your mail server and receive any new email that might be waiting for you, and it will be send pending messages, if any, that you have authored to your email server. Delete. Everyone knows this button allows you to delete the selected messages. Print. Sometimes you might want to keep copy of the email message with you. In such case, this button allows you to take a printout, and if your system is connected to the printer. Also see, in one click you can delete 50 messages only. Okay, by default if you see, you can delete 50 messages, okay, from the Gmail account. Now sending and receiving email message. How will you receive and send a email message? Receiving an email message, you can receive your email messages even when your computer is not turned on. Your email service provider stores that message you receive in a mailbox. Okay, the company, the email service who is providing you the internet protocol against, means internet protocol service provider, okay, he will keep your message, store your message which you will receive in a mailbox, and when you check for new message, you are in fact checking your mailbox on the service provider computer. So this means which company is providing you the service, Gmail or Hotmail, wherever you have created your account. This means that you can check your messages even when you are moving from one place to another. So you are, your service provider is Gmail. So we'll go to the Gmail and click on the inbox. Okay. Now sending an email message. You can send a message to exchange ideas or request for information. You can also reply or forward a mail that you receive or exchange ideas. You can also see, while sending an email, Your message should be in such way that it should convey what you exactly want to say. Okay? So you won't use a typical way to write the message. Okay? Simple way, simple words, so that a person who is reading your mail should understand, okay, the thing would, or the message which you want to say. For this, you will have to compose your message in a concise and meaningful way. Okay. So see, some email service providers allow you to use comma between the email address so that you can use more addresses, more than one email address. And some email service providers allow you to use a semicolon between the email address to indicate there is more than one email address. So you can also use the address book to choose if you want to send the recipient the email via 2CC or the BCC field. Now next, common email terms which we have seen in the previous class, okay, but not completed because of the less time. So now there are some common email terms that you can use while composing the messages. Okay, writing style, your message. So writing style, your message should be clear, concise, and should contain no spelling or grammatical error. Okay, also make sure that your message should not be misunderstood. Okay, sometimes what happens, you just write a message and send to the person, but by mistake he doesn't understand the message, okay, in a proper way, and the person misunderstood the message and gives you a different answer. So please write it simply. There should be no spelling or grammatical mistake. It should be clear, concise. Now you see smileys. You can use special characters, okay, which is called as smileys or emoticons, to express emotions in messages. If you want to show the emotion in the message, like as we are doing using a WhatsApp we can see, or a Facebook we can see these emoticons. Okay, the symbol is for cry, smiley, laugh, sad, wow, wink, great, screaming, tongue out, kissing, angel, cloning. Okay, so these are the smileys which you can use in your messages, and these characters resemble human faces if you turn them sideways. Now next, if you see after the smileys there is an abbreviation which is the very much helpful part in email terms, commonly used in messages, that you can use to save time while typing. Here are some of the most commonly used abbreviations which you can write in your message, like AISI, as I see it, ASAP, as soon as possible, B4N, bye for now, BAK, back at keyboard, now BBIAB, be back in a bit, BBL, be back later, TC, take care, BTW, by the way, see you, I see, love you, laughing out loud, see you soon, and great. So these are some abbreviation words which you can use in your messages. Okay, now next comes shouting. A message written in capital letters is annoying and hard to read. This is called shouting. Okay, if all the messages are written in capital, so you are just, they are annoying and irritating you to read. Okay, they are hard to read. While you are having the combination of both upper and lower case, that will be helpful in typing messages also and reading also. Okay, so the capital letters in a message is known as shouting. It is not that shouting which you do in classes. Okay. Now next one is bounced message. What is this bounced message? A message that returns to you because it cannot reach its destination is called bounced message. As the money transactions you have seen, when you don't have a money in your account, it returns back to you. Okay, a message usually bounces because of mistake in typing email address. If you have written a wrong email address, it will bounce back. So make sure that you check the receiver's email address for accuracy before you send the message. Okay, so hope these all things are clear to you all. Now next one is your signature. Okay, you can add information about yourself at the end of every message you send. Whatever message you are sending through email, at last you can add some details through an email program, and this is called a signature. Okay, this prevents you from having to type the same information over and over again. So a combination of your name, email address or favorite remarks can act as your signature in your email message. So this is also very helpful, that writing a long information about yourself, instead of that you can just use a combination of your name, email address or your favorite remarks and just as a signature. Now we are going to talk about the attachment. Most email messages consist only of text, but you can also attach some other types of information to share. Okay, what happened when you are sending an email message, you think that only a text we can do, but you can attach some other types of information also. Like this could be a photo, a spreadsheet file, okay, a word processing document, or any data that resides in a separate file. These all things you can attach. Even the videos also you can attach with your email and send to the other person. You can attach any of these files to an email message, and when you attach a file and send the message, the file is sent along with the email. Okay, so these are get uploaded, and then with your email message they reach to the destination, and the other person download them and see the photo or the document or the video which you have attached with your email. Okay, clear to you all? Now creating an email account in Gmail. How will you create an email account in your Gmail? So electronic mail or email is used to send messages electronically from one place to another. But to use this facility, we need to get registered with an email service provider to get our email ID. Is of course, if it doesn't get registered to the service provider, how you will get an email ID? And without email ID, you can't send messages. You need an address. So start Internet Explorer and enter the web address www.gmail.com in the address bar. What happened? Gmail login page will appear on the screen. Then click on the link create an account, or you can see sign in or create an account. So earlier you are not registered, that's why you can't sign in. So create an account. Firstly, enter your first name and the last name in the form. And after that, enter the desired login name. Whatever login name you want, you can write it. If someone else has taken the same login name, means you are writing your name, and if the same name has been taken by someone else earlier, then a message will appear. Someone already has this username. Then try another. It shows you the choices from where you can select the new user name. So you want some other options also. If you can just suggest a new name, then also you can use, otherwise you will get an options, you can select from them. Once your login name is selected, enter a password of minimum 8 characters. It's minimum, maximum you can have, but you have to remember also the passwords. Repeat the same password in the box called re-enter password. Again you will enter. So fill the rest of the entries in the form as they asked, and finally click the button I accept or continue to Gmail. Okay. Then what happened? Fill the rest of the entries in the form as they are asked, and finally click the button I accept or continue to Gmail. Then if all the entries are correctly added by you, you will get a confirmation for your new account, and now your new email address is loginname@gmail.com. You will have the login name over here. Okay, here you will have the login name, and then @gmail.com, the service provider name, the company name. Now username can contain letters from A to Z, numbers from 0 to 9, dashes, underscore and periods, means full stop. Username can't contain an equal to sign, brackets, plus sign, more than one period in a row. Okay, these also you know, these are the rules that you can't have in your user names. Sending and receiving an email in Gmail. The first, if there is a network, okay, I'm going to show you how you will going to have your, means how you create an account in Gmail. Okay. www.gmail.com. Enter. It will take little bit time to open, okay, because of the network issue. Now it is not opening because of some network issue. I will show to you, okay, wait for 10 to 4 minutes. I will just show you how you will create a Gmail, okay, ID, email account on Gmail. Okay, so coming to the textbook, let me close this. Sending and receiving email in Gmail, let's see this. After creating the email account, you can share it with your friends and relative to send you mail messages and to read your incoming mails. Once you have created your email account, then you can log into your account and share with your friends, okay, your ID, and not the password, okay, only ID, and through the ID the friends can send you the email message, and you can read also the incoming mails and send also. So follow these steps using your login ID and password. First of all, what you have to do, you have to start your Internet Explorer once again and enter the web address www.gmail.com in the address box. Next, click on the go button or press enter to key to open the Gmail login page. Okay. After this, click in the username box. Okay. Username box, and type your login ID which we have created. Make sure that the letters are typed in the same case as they were typed while creating an account. Remember this thing. This is a very important point, that as you have created your username while signing up, while creating an account, only the same letters, okay, in the same format you have to write your login ID, means username. No changes will be accepted by this. Now enter the password in the text box where the password is written, which appear in the form of black dots or asterisk. Click sign in button to open your mailbox. It will show you the list of all your incoming mails. You can now click any one of them to open and read the contents of that mail. So once you have opened it, then you will see the different options also, which I will tell you later. Now you can click inbox button, which is given there under the compose one, coming back to your mailbox. To send an email, click the compose button to open compose mail web page, means to create a mail for sending, to create a message, you will click on compose button. In the to, where it is written to box, write the email address of your friend, relative, anyone to whom you want to send the mail. Now, write the subject and then type the message in the space provided. After that, click on send button. Your mail will be sent to the recipient. And close your mailbox by clicking sign out link. Okay, when you are signing in, the sign in and then sign out. Okay. Now, I hope you all have understood. I will also show you the procedure. Okay. When there will be a proper network, I will show you. Now, email etiquette. While sending a message through email, we must follow certain rules, some of which are stated below. What are the rules? First one, your message should have a subject line that conveys its contents clearly. Okay. So whatever message you are sending, it must have a content clearly written so that it can be understood by a message that what type of message you are sending or it has what type of matter. Can you send me your CD is better than send CD. Okay. Send CD, not mailing hole, but can you send me the CD? This can be there. Then the message should be simple and to the point. Okay. Your email is a short note rather than a letter of history. When you are sending an email, it's not to be too long, okay, like a letter. It's a short note. You are sending the main points, the specific things which you need. The email message should not be in capital letters because it will called as shouting. So this is the message equivalent to shouting. You see here it is given. Okay. So it cannot be written in capital letters. While including funny comments, you should add smileys because on the telephone, it is easy to tell if someone is joking from the tone of his or her voice. But people can easily misunderstand the tone of email if it doesn't include emoticons. If the emoticons were not there, then they will not understand your feelings or emotions which you want to express in that message and hope they can misunderstand it. Okay? So, most email messages do not show bold italic letters when they display a message. So, there is no need to include them. An email is not always private and messages can accidentally to be sent to the wrong persons also. So please take care of what you write and where you send it. Remember this while writing your email address. Okay. Read once when you have written. Read once your message, check it the email address and all the things, then click on send button. So these are the important points which you must remember, the rules to follow while sending an email. Okay. So as you can see here, the page has opened. Google, sign in to continue to Gmail. Here it is given email or phone, forget email. Okay. And not your computer, use the guest mode to sign in privately. And next. This is the login page. Here it is given create account. So on this you have to click. Okay. for myself or to manage my business. So if you are personal, if you want a personal email, then for myself. Okay. See what happened next. You will get a form which you have to fill. As you have seen the steps in your book, it is given. Okay. Here it is given the steps in your book. Okay, so as same, you have seen this. Now you will see this form which is given over here. It takes a little bit time, then it will show you. Now after etiquettes, I think the chapter is also completed. Okay, in this we have seen many things about the email. And I hope now you don't have any problem, any trouble while creating a Gmail ID or sending an email. Okay. So see, the form has also came. Here what you have to give? The first name. Okay. Like if you want to give the first name, any name you can give. Okay. Just for example of the demo, I'm giving Atul Mishra. Okay, now next, it is showing me the username AtulM2126. If you like, then you can use it, otherwise you can change it also. You can take ATM with the number which you can remember, 0786. Okay, now passwords 8 with maximum letters and numbers. So can you mix up? Yes, we can mix it also. A see, the username is taken, means this username has been taken by someone. Okay, see the message which has came. What I have to do? I have to change this. So I can't able to take this, so I will just put 2000. Now password, see, next. Okay, once we have created ATMs 0786200@gmail.com, you will get this page after next. See, here you will write the phone number, recovery email address, if any. If you want that, if you sometimes you forgot your email ID or password, it will send to your recovery email address. Then month, day, year, gender, and then again next. Okay, if you do this, then at last what happens? That will send you an OTP to your number, and then it will be created. Okay, so I don't want to create because I am already having the email. Okay, so that's why by this you can create your what? Gmail ID. Okay, and like this, if you send, then here when you have creating your account, when a page comes here, a login page, after creating your Gmail ID, you can directly enter your what username and password, and then clicking on sign in. Okay, so that will open your Gmail account. Okay, I hope clear to you all this thing. So here we have completed the question answers, and in the next class we will be discussing the exercise session, and hope this is the last chapter of our syllabus also. So we will complete that and the course will be completed. Okay, so you will also find out the question answers, the exercise by yourself. Okay, and after completing this, we will go for the revision session also. And in that, we will have, I think, So we will do the practicals, theory mix, and I hope if any doubt is there, that will be cleared in the revision session. Okay. So thank you. Till then, good day.